Hello friends, this is Jayaraj, lecturer from Government Women's Polytechnic Holayanasapura, welcoming you all to this third session of Unit 4 of Hydraulics and Pneumatics, that is Hydraulic Machines. So in our last class, we had discussed about Pelton wheel and Francis turbine, and we had completed few worked examples on it also. So in this session, we'll be extending our discussion to the next part of the chapter, that is coupland turbine. So before that, we'll be having a brief recap of the previous session, and we'll be moving on to coupland turbine, that is one of the axial flow type of turbine, and we'll be seeing in brief about the construction and working of the coupland turbine, and we'll be working out a simple numerical example on coupland turbine also, and we'll be discussing with block diagram a hydroelectric power plant. What is the model or the format with which the hydroelectric power plants works overall? We'll be looking at it, and we'll be having a small discussion about pumps in this class. So regarding Francis turbine that we had discussed in our previous class, Francis turbine was a mixed flow turbine where the flow was entering radially and it was leaving axially. So axial, when I say radial, it was entering radially to the axis of the shaft and it was leaving axially. So here we are able to see the Francis turbine, a power plant with installed Francis turbine in its capacity. So the head range with which the Francis turbine works is typically 40 to 600 meters, and the speed with which the Francis turbine works is up to 1000 to 1500 rpm. So depending on with the higher head, the rpm still it goes higher. So, and the power output that is obtained is up to 1500 megawatts also. So we are obtaining 1500 to 1800 megawatts with a modern Francis turbine. So Francis turbine, as I told you earlier, it is a mixed flow turbine where the flow enters radially and leaves the turbine axially. So radial in the sense, the radial, it is perpendicular to the direction or the axis and leaves parallel to the axis. So here we are able to see the tail race, the entry from the penstock pipe and enters the spiral casing, so which was the main component of the Francis turbine we had seen earlier. It enters the spiral casing and takes the vortex casing, so where the area of the cross section is continuously reducing, and enters the runner through the guide blades, and once it transfers its all the energy, that is hydraulic energy, into mechanical energy, it leaves the turbine to the trail race through a draft tube. So here we are able to see a draft tube, so through which the water reaches the tail race. So in today's class, we'll be learning coupland turbine. So coupland is an axial flow reaction turbine. So we had seen what exactly is a reaction turbine. So when we say reaction turbine, so we should understand there is both kinetic energy as well as potential energy available with the water that is coming inside. So dam in the penstock mukantara turbine ge baruvanta flow nalli we have both the kinetic energy and pressure energy. So innondu tara turbine nodidvi, that was called as impulse turbine. So impulse turbine nalli namge inlet energy bandu very kinetic energy agittu. The energy that was available at the inlet was only kinetic energy, but in the reaction turbine the energy that is available is both kinetic energy as well as potential energy. So during the flow through a runner, the potential energy partially get transformed into kinetic energy. So turbine mukantara flow agbekadre potential energy anadu part agi kinetic energy agi convert agutte. So when we say axial flow turbine, so the flow takes place parallel to the axis. So here we are able to see the shaft of the turbine. So this is the axis, let us say. So if this is considered as the axis of the turbine or the shaft, the flow takes place parallel to it, so hence we call it as axial flow. The flow is along the direction of the axis. So coupland turbine is an axial flow reaction turbine. So coupland turbine has few important components which we'll be looking at today. So in this figure we are mainly able to observe the entry of water into the scroll casing. So the water enters from the penstock pipe, so reservoir ninda penstock pipe na mukantara bandantaha water having both kinetic energy and the pressure energy, so enters the scroll casing. So scroll casing na enter aada kudle, it takes 90 degree turn. So Francis turbine nalli there was no turn, so ಸ್ಪೈರಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಬಂದಂತ ನೀರು ಗೈಡ್ ವೇನ್ಸ್ ನ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ರನ್ನರ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಫ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ನ ಒಳಗೆ, ಸಿ ದ ಔಟರ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ನ ಒಳಗೆ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಫ್ಲೋ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎ 90 degree ಟರ್ನ್. ಸೊ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ದಿ ರನ್ನರ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎ 90 degree ಟರ್ನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಆಕ್ಸಿಯಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೀಗೆ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಫ್ಲೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ದಿ ರನ್ನರ್. ಸೊ ರನ್ನರ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಲಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ ರೊಟೇಟ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಬ್ಲೇಡ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ರನ್ನರ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ರನ್ನರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್, ದ ಶಾಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಎಂಡ್, ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಎಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಶಾಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ this is the smaller end and this is the larger end. So on this larger end, which is also called as the hub or boss, idana hub athwa boss ant heli karitivi. So ee larger end of the shaft that is called as hub or the boss, so there are blades which are axially curved blades. So these axially curved blades may be fixed or may have provision. This axially curved blades on the hub which together forms runner. So ee blades ee hub ge attach agirodre ee attach agiruvanta blade ee hub ge attach agide. So ee eradannu seri naavu runner anta heli karitivi. So ee runner mele attach agiruvanta blade is having a provision, it is pivoted at the central position, so it is having a provision to rotate. So the blades can be rotated, so looking at the load condition. So at higher load the blade position will be different, at lower or smaller load the blade positions will be different. So the Kaplan turbine has a provision wherein the blade angle can be varied. So these are axially curved vanes. So when the flow enters the runner axially, it transfers all its hydraulic energy, tannalliro shakti ellanu blades ge delivery madutte. So ee delivery madodrinda so it starts rotating. So the hydraulic energy has been transformed into mechanical energy, that is rotation form of energy, hence the turbine rotates and the water leaves to the tail race. So after giving all its energy to the runner, so it goes out, it comes out into the tail race. So during this flow, so we have various components attached with the Kaplan turbine. So here we are able to see the various components associated with the Kaplan turbine. The first component is the scroll casing. The scroll casing is similar to the spiral casing of the Francis turbine, where the water from the penstock pipe enters first. So here we are able to see a small video clipping of a Kaplan turbine. So we are able to see the hub on which vanes are attached. So both together are called as the runner. So the runner has been surrounded by the scroll casing. So here we are able to see the scroll casing here. The water enters here into this scroll casing. So this scroll casing is of continuously reducing cross sectional area. So it continuously reduce aagthiranta cross section area yathakke ante heli naavu nodidivi already. So because of the reduction in the cross section area, so pressure enagutte, so pressure get transformed into velocity energy. So at constant velocity, so ee guide vanes, so illi nodta idivi guide vanes galu dwarapalakaragi kelsa maartave. So through this guide vanes flow ಅನ್ನೋದು ರನ್ನರ್ ನ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದಿ ಗೈಡ್ ವೇನ್ಸ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೂಟಬಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಲೋಡ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ನ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಬಂದಂತಹ ನೀರು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಈ ಗೈಡ್ ವೇನ್ಸ್ ಗಳ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ರನ್ನರ್ ನ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗ್ತವೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಫ್ಲೋ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಂಗ್. So the flow starts entering through the guide vanes into the runner. So it takes a 90 degree turn. So here we are able to see runner na muttodike munchene it is taking a 90 degree turn and converting itself into parallel to the axis. Axis ke parallel aagi change aagta ide. So these are the axially curved vanes. So we are able to see the curved blades over here. When the flow passes through this blades, it starts rotating because of the energy that has been given to it from the water. So here are the few components, a 2D diagram of the couple and turbine. So this is the scroll casing, a cut section view of the scroll casing. It is completely full of water. So when it is completely full of water, we can understand there is both pressure energy as well as kinetic energy associated with it. So the scroll casing with full of water enters the guide vanes here. Here we are able to see the guide vanes. Guide vanes mukantra bandhu 90 degree turn aage. It changes itself to axial flow. So axis ke parallel aada flow aage convert aage. It passes through the vanes athwa runner. So when it passes through the vanes or the runner, it transfers all its energy to make it rotate. So once it starts rotating, the energy of the water is transformed to the blades. The water at lower velocity goes to the tail race through the draft tube. So draft tube na purpose, you know, we have already seen. So in this class also we'll be looking into the main objectives of the draft tube. So this is how a couple and turbine works. So the shaft of the couple and turbine, I already told you, is vertical with its lower end made larger, and it is known as the boss or the hub. So the vanes on the hub, which are distributed at equal interval together, it is called as the runner. So this is the enlarged portion of the shaft. It is called as the boss or the hub. So over this boss, so we have the runner, which are spaced at equal interval and having provision for rotation of the blades. The angle can be adjusted, so there will be a provision. So the turbine which is having provision for rotation of the blades or changing the angle of the blade is called as the coupland turbine. When these blades are not having any provision, rotation madodakke yavade anukoolate illade hodaga, when the blades are fixed, then it is called as the propeller turbine. So eradukku iruvanta sanna vyathasa ishte. So when blade angle can be changed, we call the turbine as the coupland turbine. When the blade angle cannot be changed, so we are calling the same turbine as the propeller turbine. So apart from that, the working are one and the same. The main part of the parts of the coupland turbine are the scroll casing. So we have seen the scroll casing. Through the scroll casing only the flow enters the turbine and it starts flowing around the runner and starts entering the guide vane mechanism. So the guide vane mechanism has all provisions for rotation and control of angle. So ee guide vanes gala mukantra enagutte, so neeru runner na serutte. So ee guide vanes gala angle na navu control maadkolabodu load requirement na aadharad mele. So when the load is more, so we are allowing more water, more discharge we are allowing. When the load is less, we are allowing less water, less entry of water to the runner. So hub or the runner, we know the enlarged portion of the shaft, it is called as the hub. On this, the blades are attached at equal intervals and together it is called as the runner. So the diameter of it forms DO and heli karitivi. So the diameter of the only the hub is called as the DF, or we can call it as D1 also. These are the terminologies that we use. So the hub together with the runner. So if this is the hub whose diameter is DF, let us say, along with the blades, if blades are attached on this, the outer diameter is called as the D0. So this is the terminology that we will be using in order to solve the problem. So DF is the smaller diameter, that is diameter of the hub. D0 is the outer diameter that includes the blade as well as. So when we need to find out the area of flow, we need to subtract one from the other. So next, the important component is the draft tube. We know the purpose of draft tube. Draft tube enables a negative pressure at the exit of the turbine. So suppose if this is the turbine, the draft tube has been attached to it. So the draft tube has two main purposes. One is it ensures a negative pressure at the exit, leading to increase in net pressure. So net pressure na jaasti madodakkagi, so it maintains a negative pressure at the exit of the turbine, and also it ensures that the turbine has been attached at a greater height compared to the tail race. If this is the tail race level, so neerna level agirutte, so ee turbine na naavu certain height nalli maintain madodakke ee draft tube namge sahaya martave. These are the main objectives with which we are using draft tube. So different types of draft tubes will be looking at in our today's class. So couple and turbine terminologies I already told you. So the discharge is given by the formula of product of area and velocity. So A is the cross sectional area through which the flow occurs. So it is given by pi by 4 d naught square minus df square, so into vf1. vf1 is the velocity of the flow, so it remains same at the inlet and exit also. So d naught is the outer diameter of the runner and df is the diameter of the hub. So vf is the velocity of the flow at the inlet. So velocity of the flow at the inlet and the outlet remains one and the same for the couple and turbine. And the speed of the turbine, so peripheral speed u1 equal to u2, so it remains same at the entry as well as exit. u1 is equal to u2, given by pi dn by 60. So here we are using the outer diameter d naught in the numerator. So vf1 is equal to vf2, velocity of flow at the inlet as well as velocity of the flow at the exit, both remains the same. Area of the flow at the inlet equal to outlet, so here it is given by the d naught square minus db square, pi by 4 into d naught square minus db square. So let us look at a worked example on a couple and turbine, a simple worked example. A couple and turbine operating under a net head of 20 meters. So a couple and turbine is working at a head of 20 meters. So H here is 20 meters. It develops a power of 20,000 kilowatts. So it is developing a much higher power of 20,000 kilowatts with an overall efficiency. So here we are able to see the overall efficiency. So in our last class, we had seen the overall efficiency is given by the ratio of shaft power divided by the water power. So the shaft, the output power that was delivered by the shaft divided by the water power, the overall water power that is available at the inlet. So that efficiency is called as the overall efficiency. It is given as 86%. The speed ratio is 2.0 and the flow ratio is 0.6. The hub diameter of the wheel is 0.35 times the outside diameter. Here the hub diameter is given. So hub diameter is nothing but DF. It is nothing but 0.35 times the outside diameter. So 0.35 times D naught. 0.35 times D naught and heli kottidare. So we have to find out the diameter. See, we know the hub diameter, it is 0.35 times the outside diameter. So we need to find out the diameter here, which is nothing but the outside diameter, with which we'll be able to say what is the hub diameter or the inner diameter and the speed of the turbine. So both we have to find out. The speed of the turbine is given by U. U is nothing but pi dn by 60. So we need to find out the U also. So the given parameters are H equal to head 20 meters, power developed by the turbine is 20,000 kilowatts. So U is given by 0.45 times V1. So, and the overall efficiency is 0.86, and the diameter of the hub is 0.35 times the diameter of the runner. So the speed ratio is given. So in order to find out the speed of the couple and turbine, it is given by the formula U equal to speed ratio into root of 2gh. So in our last discussions, we were using the velocity coefficient here. So here we'll be using the speed ratio here. So U is equal to root of 2gh. So we know 2 into g, so head is 20 meters. So here we are able to find out the U1, that is 39.6 meters per second. So VF1, so here the flow ratio is given. So VF1 is equal to flow ratio into root of 2gh. The flow ratio is given in the problem. It is 0.6 multiplied with root of 2gh. H is 20 meters of head. So we are obtaining the velocity VF1, that is velocity of flow at the inlet, as 11.9 meters per second. So we have U1 and VF1 now. So we also know that U1, that is velocity at the inlet, peripheral speed of the blade at the inlet and exit are one and the same, and the velocity of the flow at the inlet and exit are both same. So with this, we'll be able to find out the discharge now using the equation of overall efficiency. Overall efficiency is given by the formula shaft power divided by water power. Shaft power is already given to us. So in the problem itself, so it says 20,000 kilowatts and water power can be found out using the formula rho q g into h. So rho q is specific weight of the water, so it has been replaced by w. So we have q into h, h is known, 20 meters. So and we have to find out q over here, given the overall efficiency as 0.86. so with this we'll be able to find out what is q. Q is 118.5 meter cubes per second. So the formula for discharge is given by q equal to pi by 4 into d naught square minus df square multiplied by v of 1. So it is also given that the df, that is the hub diameter, is 0.35 times the overall diameter of the runner. So replacing df in terms of d naught, so we'll be able to get this equation. So substituting the value of q and vf1, we'll be able to obtain the diameter d naught. So the value of vf1 we had already find out. So substituting the value of q and vf1 in the above equation, so we are able to find out the value of d naught. So d naught is 3.8 meters. So it is, d naught is nothing but the outer diameter of the runner. Next, the equation to find out the speed of the turbine. So we know the u from our previous calculation. So it is given by pi d naught into n divided by 60. So here the peripheral speed is 39.6 from our previous calculation, equal to pi into 3.8, that is d naught obtained from this equation, divided by 60. So we have n here, which we need to find out now. So calculating this, so we'll be able to find out the value of speed, that is 198 revolutions per minute. So this is a typical problem on coupland turbine, so very easiest one. So having discussed different types of turbines, working and construction of different types of turbines, let us have a broader look at a hydroelectric power plant. So hydroelectric power plant consists of various components when we look at a macro level. So first is extraction of water from the reservoir. Here we have a reservoir at certain higher level, so which gives us the head of water h. So water has been taken from the reservoir into the power station through a pipe called the penstock pipe, which we had discussed already. So these penstock pipes delivers the water or carries the water from the reservoir and delivers it to the turbine. So here we have a penstock pipe which is carrying water into the power station. So here we are able to see the anchor blocks, so which are nothing but the support blocks. So this supports the penstock pipes and also it takes the shock that occurs because of the flow of the water at the higher pressure. So they are called as the anchor blocks. So and here we have the surge tanks. So these surge tanks ensures the flow to be shock free. So when we say shock free, so these surge tanks ensures that there is no water hammer during the flow of water in this penstock pipes. So water from this penstock pipes enters the turbine through the various guide vanes, steerings, etc. So and once it transfers all its hydraulic energy into mechanical energy, that is rotation of the turbine. So the turbine are coupled to the generator in the power station. So when the turbine starts rotating, the shaft attached to it rotates, and which itself is coupled to a generator, and hence it produces electricity. So the water energy has been transformed completely into electric energy. So and once the all the energy that has been extracted from the water, and water reaches the tail race, that is the bottommost level that a water finally goes and reaches. So here we are able to see few main components of the hydroelectric plant, that is the penstock pipe. So we have discussed already. So penstock pipe carries water from the reservoir and delivers it to the turbine here. So next is the surge tank, which ensures the flow is completely shock free and free of any water hammers here. And the anchor blocks, acts as a support for the penstock pipe. So penstock pipes are distributed for a few kilometers, and anchor blocks ensures that they are supported at regular intervals. So draft tube, we have discussed. So they ensures that a negative pressure is ensured at the exit of the turbine and ensures a net increase in head or net pressure increase. So the net pressure at this turbine is increased because of the negative pressure maintained at the exit of the turbine, and also it maintains the turbine at certain height and delivers the water to into the tail race at lesser velocity. So the velocity of the water leaving the turbine will be reduced, transforming this energy. So this is the function of the draft tube in the hydroelectric power plant. So looking at draft tube micro view, so draft tubes are tubes of gradually increasing cross section area. So draft tube na area bando continuous agi increase aagtane irutte. So it is not of a constant cross sectional area. So nodabodu naavu, so continuous agi area increase aagtane irutte. So area na naavu increase maado uddesha eno, so flow na velocity na kadame maadi pressure na jaasti maado uddeshadalli, so area na naavu jaasti maartaa hogtive continuous agi. So it acts in a reverse way of a nozzle. Tube connects the outlet of the runner into the tail race. So nama turbine nalli ola bandantaha neeru after transforming its energy into the runner, it leaves the turbine and connects the tail race, and it has to reach the tail race. So this draft tube helps the water to reach the tail race. It permits a negative pressure head at the outlet of the turbine, so it permits a negative pressure over here. So yake anta helidre, so we have to maintain a higher net pressure in the working of this turbine, hence a negative pressure at the exit is has to be maintained, which is done by this draft tube. The turbine can be replaced at a certain height. So nama tail race ninda navu turbine na certain height alli idbeku. Suppose this is the tail race, let us say. So ee tail race ninda nanu certain height nalli turbine na place maadbeku. This is the turbine, so this has to be maintained at sufficient height. Yake ant helidre, so it ensures other inspection and other installation works will be easier. It has to be always maintained at certain height from the tail race. So this draft tube serves the purpose. So draft tube helps in maintaining the turbine at certain height from the tail race. So also this draft tube converts the velocity energy into pressure energy. So neer energy na turbine ge transfer maadi hora bartha iruvanta neeru, it has some velocity energy. So ee velocity energy na ee continuously increasing cross sectional area iruvanta draft tube en maartta ide pressure energy agi convert maartta ide, so thereby reducing the velocity of the water at the exit and transforming it into pressure energy. So draft tube nalli we have different types of draft tubes. So one simpler type of draft tube is the conical type draft tube. So here we are able to see a conical type of draft tube with increasing cross sectional area. So ili turbine connect agirutte, so turbine inda bandanta neeru tail race na reach agodike this draft tube kelsa maartta ide. So area increase aagta ide yake pressure na adu jaasti maadbekide, velocity na kadame maadi pressure na increase maadbekagide. Simple elbow type draft tube, so here we are able to see ee conical tube straight agide, it is a straight conical tube. So and here a simple elbow type tube, so elladara area bandu continuous agi increase aagtane irutte, constant cross section area draft tube. So the elbow draft tube with circular inlet and rectangular outlet. So the elbow draft tube here we are able to see it is having a circular inlet and the rectangular outlet. So this is one form of the draft tube with continuously increasing cross sectional area. So this can be installed depending on the place where the turbine has been installed, depending on the design of installation. So we'll be choosing the different type of draft tube, and also draft tube has its own efficiency. So it is found out that the conical and the Moody's type of draft tube as the highest efficiency. So we have the efficiency of the draft tube given as in the ratio of actual conversion of kinetic head into pressure head over the kinetic head at the inlet of the draft tube. So this is the equation for the draft tube efficiency. So it depend, it is given by the ratio of actual conversion of kinetic head into the pressure head. So what how much of energy has been converted into pressure energy actually over the kinetic head that is available at the inlet of the draft tube or the exit of the turbine. So depending on this efficiency, we have the highest efficiency with the conical draft tube and the Moody's type of draft tube. So both these are having the highest efficiencies compared to the other two. So next, moving on to pumps. So in our first class itself, we had seen the hydraulic machines to be of two type. One is power generating type, another one is power absorbing type. So power generating type utilizes the hydraulic energy and transform it into mechanical energy, and thereby it converts it into electrical energy. So in power absorbing type, so electrical energy is utilized in order to convert it into some form of energy, some form of mechanical energy, let us say pressure energy, for example. So this is the fundamental difference with the hydraulic machines. One is the power generating type and the power absorbing type. So pump is the power absorbing type hydraulic machine. So in all our previous discussion, we had seen the power generating type. All the turbines are power generating type of hydraulic machines. So the power absorbing type of hydraulic machines are pumps. For example, we had given a simple example of ceiling fan. Ceiling fan is a hydraulic machine which is power absorbing. It absorbs the current or the electrical energy and gives the output as the rotation. So pumps are also of a similar type of power absorbing machines, absorbs electricity and delivers mechanical energy or the hydraulic energy as an output. So pumps are devices which converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. So this mechanical energy is because of the electrical energy only. So earlier, in earlier days, steam was used in order to drive the pumps. But in modern days, all the pumps are run by electric motor itself. So electrical energy transformed into mechanical energy, which itself is transformed into hydraulic energy. So pumps convert the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. The hydraulic energy is in the form of pressure energy. So let us take a simple example of our house itself. So we'll pump the water from the sump into the overhead tank at certain height, let us say. So here we'll be having the pump, so which accepts the input in the form of the electricity and gives this water some form of hydraulic energy, that is called as the pressure energy. So ee pressure energy inda, so neer enagta ide, it is taking a lift to certain height. So hydraulic energy here is transformed into a pressure energy. So we are transforming this energy into form of a pressure energy, because of which it is just transferring itself to a greater height. So this power absorbing machines can be broadly classified into two types. One is rotodynamic pumps and another one is the displacement type of pumps. So as the name itself says, rotodynamic pumps has some form of circular rotating member. So this circular rotating member transforms the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. So this displacement pumps, so is a positive displacement pumps, has some form of the positive confinement on the piston cylinder arrangement na dagirutte displacement pump, so which ensures that the water or any fluid is confined within this positive space, and it gives energy to it because of this positive containment. So let us see this rotodynamic pumps. Rotodynamic pumps has the continuous energy transfer interaction because of the rotating action of the impeller or the blades. Just like our turbines, the exact opposite of the turbine working, the pump works in the opposite way of the turbine. So here we have the rotating member. Here we are able to see the water enters axially and leaves it radially. So here the water is entered or sucked at the inlet axially, and because of this rotating action, this rotating action dynamically transforms this mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. So one udaharane, so we have centrifugal pump over here. So fan is also a similar rotodynamic pump, so which rotates and imparts some velocity into the air. So another type of pumps is a positive displacement pump. So a fluid is moved by trapping a fixed amount of fluid and forcing the trapped volume into the pump's discharge. So in simple, we can understand positive displacement pump as a positive confinement region. So we have a closed region, so within which a fluid is confined here, a positive confinement. So we'll have a piston cylinder arrangement, so where this fluid is pushed and hence some form of energy in the form of pressure or velocity is given to it. So let us say pressure energy is given to it because of this positive confinement. So positive displacement pump has a positive confinement which has the highest efficiency compared to the rotodynamic pump. So here we are able to see the piston pump, and our simple hand pump is also a positive displacement pump. So where the water confined to certain fixed region is pushed in order to attain a higher pressure. So I thank you all for your patience, and let us continue the discussion on pumps in detail in our next class. So you can avail this video. So in this YouTube link, so you can get all the videos, in fact, through our DTE Studio channel, through our website dte.kr.nic.in. Thank you all.